unmatched innovation, and fierce competition. Let's start with the exciting and highly anticipated showdown between industry giants, Blue Origin and SpaceX. With their flagship initiatives, New Glenn and Starship, Jeff Bezos and his team have a strategic advantage in their intention to accelerate the launch of New Glenn, positioning themselves to effectively challenge SpaceX. What lies ahead? Can this advantageous position allow Blue Origin to surpass SpaceX? Let's explore the potential outcomes in today's episode of NR Studio. The year 2020 proved to be quite disappointing for Blue Origin, as the company dedicated the entire year to preparing for its maiden orbital launch, but failed to lift off. Nevertheless, in the final days of the year, they managed to conduct a very important test launch, which maintained optimism for their highly anticipated debut. With this foundation, Blue Origin is on the verge of realizing its maiden orbital launch. Although an official announcement regarding the launch date has not been made, FAA documents indicate that the launch is scheduled for January 6, 2025, with a backup date of January 7th. This timeline points to New Glenn as the first new rocket scheduled to launch in 2025. This scheduling gives Blue Origin a significant competitive advantage. The intended launch date is set before SpaceX Starship Flight 7, which, as stated by Elon Musk, is scheduled for January 10th. Launching before SpaceX gives Blue Origin a strategic advantage, allowing them to grab attention and make a big impact before being overshadowed by the highly publicized Starship mission. A delay in the launch schedule could result in New Glenn being overshadowed by SpaceX's revolutionary initiative. Blue Origin is not solely concentrating on the launch's timing. It is also intent on crafting a formidable statement through the mission itself. The inaugural flight is set to transport the Blue Ring payload, a bold choice for a nascent rocket. By deploying a payload on its inaugural flight, Blue Origin seeks to instill confidence in the capabilities of New Glenn and attain the requisite government and military launch certifications. This approach stands in stark contrast to that of SpaceX, which opted to incorporate its inaugural payload only during the sixth flight of the Starship. An additional noteworthy aspect of this inaugural mission is Blue Origin's intention to retrieve the New Glenn booster using their Jacqueline drone ship. The drone ship has been strategically repositioned offshore in anticipation of this pivotal milestone. Achieving a successful recovery of the booster on its inaugural flight would be an extraordinary milestone, particularly in light of the fact that SpaceX required several years following the initial launch of Falcon 9 to refine its booster landing techniques, and only recently attained this feat with Starship during Flight 5. Should Blue Origin achieve its ambitious objectives by launching punctually, successfully delivering its payload, and recovering the booster, it will signify a remarkable inaugural performance for New Glenn. Such a performance would establish Blue Origin as a formidable competitor in the orbital launch sector, positioning it as a significant rival to SpaceX. As the launch window of January 6th or 7th draws near, keen attention will undoubtedly be focused on the inaugural flight of New Glenn. To meet expectations and surpass the achievements of SpaceX, please share your predictions in the comments section. Please remember to express your appreciation for this video by liking it and subscribing to our channel for continuous updates on SpaceX and its competitors within the ever-evolving realm of space exploration. In my considered and modest assessment, the answer is unequivocally no. Although Blue Origin's New Glenn 1 is a bold endeavor, it is improbable that it will eclipse Space Starship Flight 7, either in terms of technical accomplishments or enduring influence. Blue Origin's aspirations for New Glenn 1 reveal a noteworthy ambition, albeit accompanied by considerable risks. The decision to incorporate payloads on its inaugural flight is an audacious strategy, especially given that neither the rocket nor the organization has attained orbital success to date. Though this may seek to demonstrate assurance in their technology, it simultaneously elevates the risks involved. Should the mission falter and the payload suffer damage, it may jeopardize Blue Origin's esteemed reputation and hinder subsequent certification endeavors. The case of ULA's Vulcan Centaur exemplifies how setbacks of this nature can initiate a series of delays that may adversely affect Blue Origin's overarching goals. Simultaneously, SpaceX's strategy with Starship Flight 7 is equally ambitious, yet it is grounded in a robust framework of established innovation and progressive achievement. SpaceX intends to once again retrieve the Super Heavy booster utilizing the Mechazilla arm, a remarkable achievement unique to their capabilities. This approach is not merely striking in its visual appeal, It also offers substantial operational benefits by facilitating swifter recovery and reuse of the booster. Although the upper stage of Starship will still execute an ocean landing during this flight, this undertaking represents a calculated advancement toward achieving complete reusability. Although Starship flight the 7th of May take off after Nuguland 1, its technological advancements, coupled with SpaceX's esteemed reputation for excellence, are poised to garner significant attention and acclaim. Nuguland's initial foray is fraught with heightened risks, stemming from the ambitious aspirations associated with it. The initiative to deploy payloads such as the Blue Ring on an inaugural flight, alongside the ambition to achieve a booster landing on subsequent voyages, reflects a bold confidence while simultaneously heightening the risk of setbacks. This is regarded as audacious, given that SpaceX spent several years reaching comparable milestones following the inaugural launch of Falcon 9. The inaugural mission of Nuguland 1 will serve to assess the capabilities of the Jacqueline drone ship, with the ambitious goal of achieving booster recovery on its initial attempt. Should these objectives remain unmet, the mission may become subject to intense scrutiny, resulting in additional delays and complications for Blue Origin. Conversely, SpaceX is utilizing its vast expertise to expand the limits of Starship's potential. The company's systematic approach, characterized by incremental progress across flight operations, effectively mitigates the risks inherent in high-stakes launches. Through the successful capture of the Super Heavy booster and the enhancement of Starship systems, SpaceX is setting the stage for an entirely reusable rocket system. The iterative development of Starship guarantees that identified issues are systematically resolved, thereby minimizing the potential for catastrophic failures. Upon assessing the long-term competitive landscape, it becomes evident that SpaceX possesses substantial advantages. Blue Origin aspires to execute 25 Nuguland 1 launches throughout 2025, a target that seems excessively ambitious in light of the delays encountered during its inaugural flight. These launches are essential for Blue Origin to position itself as a dependable provider for missions such as NASA's Escapade, Amazon's Kuiper satellite program, and an array of government contracts. Nonetheless, any setbacks or shortcomings in the initial missions of New Glenn may result in a backlog, thereby challenging Blue Origin's capacity to fulfill its obligations and undermining the confidence of its partners. Conversely, SpaceX has meticulously orchestrated a framework for an accelerated frequency of Starship launches anticipated in 2025. Additionally, the objective is to focus on 25 missions. The company's strategy encompasses enhancing the reusability of Starship, deploying payloads efficiently, and advancing in-orbit refueling systems. In contrast to Blue Origin, SpaceX's commitment to transparency and its agile iterative processes enable the swift identification and resolution of challenges, thereby maintaining its competitive edge in the launch sector. While Nuguland 1 seeks to validate its potential, Starship has ascended to a superior echelon of technological accomplishment. In a comparative analysis of the rockets, Starship markedly surpasses Nuguland in almost all respects, standing at an impressive height of 12 meters. Starship 5-2 significantly outstrips Eon's 98 meters. The thrust of Starship, an impressive 7,500 tons, significantly surpasses that of the N1, 750, which is propelled by 7 BE engines. This substantial thrust capacity empowers Starship to transport payloads ranging from 100 to 200 tons to low Earth orbit, in stark contrast to Nuguland's maximum capacity of 5 tons. The variance in performance highlights Starship's aptitude for audacious endeavors, ranging from lunar landings to the colonization of Mars. The design philosophy of Starship emphasizes complete reusability, a transformative attribute in the realm of spaceflight. SpaceX is diligently advancing techniques for the recovery and reutilization of both rocket stages, in addition to its heat shield and fairings. This strategy markedly lowers production expenses, thereby rendering frequent launches financially feasible. In contrast, the Nuguland 1 exhibits limited reusability, lacking definitive strategies for the recovery of both the second stage and the fairings. This constraint positions Nuguland alongside earlier generation rockets, such as the Falcon 9, which, although commendable, falls short of matching the transformative potential of Starship. The expansive landscape of the aerospace industry accentuates the distinct advantages held by SpaceX. Federal agencies, notably NASA, are progressively leaning towards innovative and economically efficient solutions, which align seamlessly with the core competencies of SpaceX. NASA Administrator Jared Isaacman recently underscored the significance of incentivizing companies that provide superior products at the most competitive prices. SpaceX's established history of innovation and punctual execution solidifies its status as a favored collaborator for forthcoming missions. Although Blue Origin continues to be a competitor, its absence of distinctive capabilities in relation to Starship diminishes its attractiveness. The performance metrics of the Nuglen 1, though commendable, do not reach groundbreaking levels, thus rendering it less appealing for high-stakes missions. In contrast, the unparalleled capabilities and cost efficiency of Starship establish it as the preferred option for ambitious endeavors, such as exploration of the Moon and Mars. Furthermore, SpaceX benefits from robust backing from the leadership of NASA. Isaacman's strong rapport with SpaceX and his prospective participation in upcoming Starship endeavors, including the Polaris Dawn projects, highlights the agency's trust in the organization. This convergence of interests further solidifies SpaceX's status as a leading force in the industry. If New Glenn faces challenges in competing with Starship, how does it fare against other rockets? While New Glenn has similar capabilities to the Falcon rocket, it may surpass it in some ways. The likelihood of it surpassing SpaceX's fleet seems highly unlikely. As of the end of 2020, SpaceX had successfully conducted a total of 132 Falcon 9 launches and two missions involving the Falcon Heavy, setting numerous benchmarks for launch success, landing precision, and reusability efficiency. With a goal of achieving an impressive benchmark of more than 180 launches by 2025, SpaceX remains a formidable leader in the aerospace industry. Barring a marked decline in Falcon rocket performance, New Glenn will likely face challenges in establishing a competitive advantage. These difficulties extend beyond SpaceX. Other companies present formidable competition for Blue Origin. For example, Rocket Lab, while a relatively small competitor in the space, has shown remarkable progress in recent years with its Electron rocket. Their upcoming Neutron rocket will significantly increase their capabilities, intensifying competition in the industry. For Blue Origin, surpassing Rocket Lab's capabilities could present a formidable challenge, let alone competing with SpaceX. Even if New Glenn makes it to orbit, the trajectory ahead for Blue Origin looks daunting. Established competitors are already well entrenched in the aerospace sector, while Blue Origin's capabilities appear to reflect the early stages of their trajectory. Similar to SpaceX, the primary competitors that Blue Origin is looking to face right now present a formidable challenge. That's it for today's episode. See you next time.